Good morning. This is our daily tarot. The opening card that we have for today is the Page of Cups. So Piscean energy is opening the day, which is so interesting because Mars and Neptune are both in Pisces right now in close proximity to one another just by a couple of degrees. And so some kind of doorway is opening and it's revealing what we really need to let go of in order for us to get through this door. So we see that this person is in this reflective state, right? They're looking into their cup. And it's as if we're looking into our own emotional nature and seeing what we put our attention on that takes us away from our aim and that we've been carrying around that actually doesn't define us. So what aspect of ourselves can we actually let go of so that we can move into this evolution? Sometimes this is signaling a true like gateway that we're going through. So when you consider the zodiac sequence, it goes from Pisces to Aries, right? And so there's some aspect of ourself that has to be let go of or dissolved in order for this more grown up or mature aspect of ourselves to be formed. So what do we let go of to be born anew? And so we're in this reflective process. And then sometimes this card can signal like a birth because it's literally like a doorway to a new beginning. And so in many ways, I just want to encourage people to realize that we really are going through this really impactful time in our lives right now. And this card is signaling that energy around Mars and Neptune being in this placement together, because you consider Mars as an energy, is this energy of fire, right? And so what opens up the door if it's not our motivation to get to the other side? So interesting as an opening card today. The challenge that we have is that there are some things that we still need to take care of. The Two of Wands, when it shows up, it's like we feel this call to go in a new direction, and yet there's also part of our will that's tied down behind us because we still have things that we need to take care of. So it's telling us to take care of these things. Make sure you put your attention on the things that are still back here weighing you down so that you have the energy and ability to move forward in the direction that you feel so called to move toward. So how do you get through that challenge? Well, we have another page that showed up, the Page of Pentacles. So this is an interesting energy by way of, you know, it has this Virgo quality to it, which is, interestingly enough, on the opposite side of Pisces. And Virgo is the energy that assimilates information and separates the coarser from the finer to see what's actually practical and what actually is useful in a scenario. And sometimes they can tend to look at things a little bit too closely, you know, like not seeing the forest because they're so busy looking at a specific tree. But when this card comes up, it's actually telling us to look at what we are actually valuing and to take consideration of, what it is that we are actually able to extrapolate value from. Because, you know, we can lead ourselves astray when we always think that what we aspire to is over there rather than right here where we are. And so it's telling us to take a look at our daily efforts, our routine. And if we can look at that in a kind of detached way, we can see perhaps where we put our energy and effort that doesn't actually tend to this thing that we need to take care of, but it's off in, you know, possible dream or illusion land, or it's so fixated on the details that, you know, it doesn't actually see the grand scheme of things. But when we consider our value system and where we put our energy, and maybe that will give us some kind of ability to manage our day a little bit more, you know, like if there's this one thing that we really aspire to create, can we be disciplined in that area and set a routine so that we can actually make an effort towards it each and every day? the ultimate outcome that we have for today is the Emperor. So this is a major arcana, which means that it's something that we don't really have choice over. And major arcanas often are a symbol of either a planet or a zodiac sign, or they're one of the mother cards. There's 22 major arcanas. The Emperor is signaling Aries energy and also Mars energy, because Mars governs Aries. And yet when we consider where what's going on in Aries right now, we just had Jupiter go into Aries. We also have Venus in Aries, and Venus right now is in really close proximity to Chiron. So the Emperor, when he shows up, it's like that authority in you that brings order to chaos. You look out on the terrain of your own life and you see where things are chaotic and something gets engaged, right? Some part of your will gets engaged because you're like, I need to go take care of that. And so this is signaling that and telling us that that will give a huge anchor in way of our direction and where we're going in life. And, you know, the Emperor is also, as I said, not only just signaling Aries, but it's also tying in that energy of Mars. Right now, we have a lot of interesting things going on astrologically, especially with this eclipse that is happening right now. Mars is also a planet that governs Scorpio, and we are having a Scorpion full moon tomorrow, which will also give us an eclipse right around 10 p.m. And eclipses on this axis can be really powerful for people who have fixed signs, or who have planets in fixed signs. And those fixed signs would be Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, or Aquarius. And so I wouldn't be surprised if this time is really impactful in your life in giving you some clarity on where you spend your day versus where you want to develop your life. And we're being called to task in that. And it's as if our own inner Emperor is being called onto the battlefield of our lives. What do we need to set in place? What do we need to bring order to? And what do we need to organize? It's on the table. I send you all a good wish through this eclipse that we will be entering into. Eclipse energies don't just last the day of the eclipse. They actually are like a series of eclipses, so it can affect us for months and months at a time. So, you know, we are in the midst of a transformation of sorts, but we will get to the other side. I send you a lot of love, and I will see you again soon. Bye for now.